Welcome my dear students of class 9A and 9B. Welcome to my history class. Today's topic, First World War. In this topic, two things you have to keep in your mind. What was the reason the First World War was taken place? And what was the impact of the First World War? But impact, I think it is not in the syllabus. You have to learn only the causes of the First World War and other, factors which led to the First World War. Now, I am going to discuss about the main points, the causes of the First World War. The main causes and the, causes. What was the reason the First World War happened? I am going to discuss. First World War, it was an incident in the history of the world awakened the people of the world because of its horror, extent, and large amount of destruction had become a great cause of horror. It resulted in horror among the people of the whole world. The people of the whole world, they never thought that a war like that must destroy the entire population, lives, and greenery. That's why they were totally unprepared to witness such a war, but ultimately it happened. There were certain factors behind it. First one, nationalism. First factor, nationalism. What is the meaning of nationalism? Nationalism means political consciousness among people of a nation, which also includes the concept of patriotism and love for one country. This is known as nationalism. In the 19th century, patriotism and love for one's own country meant hatred for others also, and also form another concept, that is hatred, that is militant nationalism. So what is the meaning of militant nationalism? What is the meaning of militant nationalism? Hatred for others means sympathy, love for one's own country, and hatred for others is known as militant nationalism. And Germany emerged as one of the most powerful races of the world before First World War. And Europe, under the leadership of Prussian Chancellor Otto von Bismarck, a war held between France and Prussia. And Germany played a vital role. Germany during that time occupied certain places. Today, one student, Rajendra Chattopadhyay, asked me in my live class, "Sir, what was the, how was Denmark affected by the Treaty of Versailles?" Very nice and good question. How was Denmark affected by the Treaty of Versailles? Already I answered it, but I must add one point more, that is, war between Germany and France, war between Germany and Prussia during Franco-Prussian War, Actually, the war started between France and Prussia. But Germany also attacked them. That's why it is said that during the Franco-Prussian War, Germany occupied the most important territory of Denmark, Schleswig. Germany occupied it. But under the Treaty of Versailles, under the terms of the Treaty of Versailles, that very territory of Denmark, Denmark got back. Denmark got back her territory, Schleswig, under the terms of the Treaty of Versailles. Germany defeated France during Franco-Prussian War and took away the province Alsace-Lorraine. Took away the province Alsace and Lorraine from France. So France also, under the terms of the Treaty of Versailles, demanded her lost territories, Alsace and Lorraine, from Germany. And France also at the same time got back her territory, lost territories, Alsace and Lorraine. The French never recovered from the French people, the French government waited to take revenge and recover their lost territories finally under the terms of the Treaty of Versailles. And other thing is that the Italians and the Balkan states of Poland, Austria, Hungary, Serbia and Bulgaria also were dissatisfied with Germany. Why? Because they, by 1914, all European countries were armed and ever ready to fight at the smallest, provocation. But Germany's aggressiveness, foreign policy, made so many countries of Europe very much dissatisfied. That's why some of them were waiting to take revenge against Germany. But Germany was determined to defeat them. It was due to the effort of Austria-Hungary. Austrian princess was assassinated, And it was also, it will be discussed later. It is also a part of this lesson, Sarajevo crisis. I shall discuss later. I shall re-explain it later. Now, next point, imperialism. The concept of imperialism, it is a part of the concept of nationalism. Because the concept of nationalism motivated a nation or a country to utilize their financial, their economic, their political, their social power over weak countries of the world. By way of doing this, so many powerful countries established their colonies over Asia, Europe and Africa. And this concept of occupying weak countries, occupying the territories of weak countries, establishing colonies over different parts of Asia, Europe and Africa, this concept, this idea is known as imperialism. This imperialistic ideals and policy of Germany, Britain, France, England gave them a strong political position in Europe and in India and throughout the world. And next one, the next point, race for armaments. Before First World War, the birth of aggressive nationalism, militant nationalism, the concept of the formation of a new concept, nationalism, motivated different countries of Europe, Asia and Africa. European countries basically became very powerful. The intense nationalism and among the European countries triggered an armament race among themselves. And it is due to that each country began preparing for war themselves. Each country of Europe, each country of Europe preparing itself for any war they wanted to win. Germany too began to increase its naval force and started large-scale production of arms and ammunition. Besides, it started digging the Kiel Canal deeper. Why? In the interest of herself, so that battleships could find shelter in its waters. And moreover, Germany began to build Berlin-Baghdad railway connecting, Berlin to Baghdad, which threatened the safety of the British colonies in the east. Naturally, this mutual hatred, this mutual jealousies and the race between the two countries for supremacy created conditions of conflict and confrontation, and the atmosphere became charged with fear, apprehension and mutual hatred. Next point, division of Europe. Europe, was divided into different parts. Why? Because of that concept, aggressive nationalism or hatred nationalism. The greatest single underlying factor for the war, First World War, was the formation of secret alliances and counter alliances before the First World War. The architect of the secret diplomacy was the Chancellor of Germany, Bismarck, Otto von Bismarck. But it happened before so many years before the First World War started. Otto von Bismarck, after the conclusion of the Franco-Prussian War in the year 1870, Germany under Bismarck felt that France might take revenge on Germany, so he wanted to isolate France. How? And in 1879, he entered into an alliance with Austria-Hungary. And this sense also benefited Germany finally. And this came to be known as the Dual Alliance in 1882. It happened. Italy joined this Dual Alliance during that period. Italy. Students, those who do, it is not a part of our syllabus, but I am discussing in detail form for only one student who asked me one question from the part, how was Germany, how was Denmark affected by the Treaty of Versailles? It was due to the effort of Otto von Bismarck during the Franco-Prussian War. The most important territory of Denmark was occupied by Germany, that was Schleswig. But under the terms of the Treaty of Versailles, Schleswig, Denmark got back her most important lost territory, Schleswig. Now, secret diplomacy, another point is that due to division of art, secret diplomacy among the European nations continued. They started forming secret alliances among themselves. And it is due to that reason, the system of secret alliances made it inevitable that if war did occur, it would involve all the big countries of Europe. And this secret diplomacy gave rise to a feeling of disrespect, distrust and hatred among various European nations, various European countries. The next point, Sarajevo crisis, another this point. Before Sarajevo crisis, I would like to conclude one more point, that is imperialism. What I started explaining earlier, but I could not complete it. Imperialism, what is the concept, what is the meaning of the concept of imperialism? There was a race of armament for colonialism, for establishing colonies all over, colonies throughout Asia, Europe, and Africa. This colonial expansion among the European countries led to the growth of a new concept that was imperialism. The imperialistic ideas, the imperialistic policy of different countries of Europe made them rivalries of each other. The rapid growth of industrialization brought great demand for colonies for raw materials throughout Asia, Europe, and Africa, and find new markets in order to establish their colonies, in order to supply their finished goods, finished products, which were produced from their factories and industries. This resulted in colonial conflicts and national rivalries. It was Germany, it was England, it was France, and later America also got themselves involved in it. Germany under Kaiser William II wanted colonies to accommodate the growing population and to satisfy the economic, prosperity, economic needs of the country. That's why each country of Europe wanted to fight for its commerce and trade. As a result of it, the entry of Germany in the race for colonies complicated the matters further. All the major powers were now involved in imperial rivalries. Britain and Germany in East, and in South, another countries in Britain and Germany in East and in South, another countries like West Africa, France, Britain and Iran and Egypt, Britain and Russia, they all, got themselves involved in these activities. And next one, another point, that is Sarajevo crisis. What is Sarajevo crisis, my dear students? Sarajevo crisis means one incident happened at the time when all the countries of Europe fully armed, fully got themselves armed and got themselves ever ready to go to war, any war they needed. During that time, one incident happened, the outbreak of Great War. And why and how? Because of that incident, Sarajevo crisis. The Serbian people became independent and wanted Bosnia to be a part of Serbia. But as Bosnia was ceded to Austria, the Serbians were agitated. That was the fact. It is not mentioned in our book, my dear students, but you have to consult many reference books so that you can attain all the answers perfectly. Bosnia became the center of rebellions and openly supported by the Serbian government. Archduke Francis Ferdinand, the heir to the throne of Austria, was murdered along with his wife Sofia at Sarajevo, a city in Bosnia, on 28th June 1914, while on a visit to Bosnia. As the assassin, princep and a 19-year-old student who was actually a Serbian, Austria blamed Serbia as the conspirator of the crime and gave an ultimatum, steep ultimatum, with 11 very, very severe demands to Serbia. almost all demands Serbia accepted, except one demand that was harming its integrity. And as a result of it, Austria refused. This refusal by Serbia means the Serbia refused. Why refuse? Because only one demand, Serbia did not want to accept. The only one demand, what Austria demanded for Serbia, only one demand Serbia did not accept, because it was a cause of their, it was a cause for breaking their national integration, breaking their national, you know, national sovereignty. That's why she did not accept the last demand. But the refusal, this refusal by Serbia turned out to be the immediate cause of the First World War. Only because of that reason, Serbia was blamed to be responsible for that incident, the assassination of Austrian prince, and princess, both of them were assassinated, and the entire political circumstances were totally changed only because of the death of Francis Ferdinand, the Austrian princess. Actually, he was apparent to the throne of Austria. Austrian prince Francis Ferdinand. But ultimately, Austria blamed Serbia, gave an ultimatum by mentioning several demands. Only one demand Serbia did not accept, and hence Austria declared war on Serbia, and the First World War, and also First World War started. Some more points I shall explain during my next class. Up to this, my dear students, thank you.